I'm Robert Calderbank. I direct the Rhodes Information Initiative here at Duke. One of the great things about Duke is that it's organized around interdisciplinarity. The purpose of the Information Initiative is to make the people here and the departments more successful than they might have been without us. And we have about 110 graduate students and postdocs in our space. If you measure prominence in machine learning in terms of how many papers did you get into the top two conferences, NeurIPS and ICML, well, we're a top 10 international institution because we get between 15 and 20. So for me, one of the special things about Duke is the efforts that we have in quantum computing. In 1948, a computer was a room full of valves. It was a big physics experiment. Today, that's exactly what a quantum computer is. We don't know that quantum computers are going to evolve in quite the way that classical computers did, but we do know that if they are, we're going to have to find ways to make them do arithmetic. So we're going to have to find ways of translating arithmetic, logical things that we want to do into physical operations. And that's one of the big challenges for the next 10 years. So me, I'm a theorist. But at Duke, there are people that actually build quantum computers. And the way that I do research is that I hang out with people that do experiments with the idea that sooner or later, if I know enough about what they do, I'll be able to do something that they can't do. And so the last year, Henry Pfister and I have been advising a graduate student, Narayanan, who works with Jungsang Kim and Ken Brown in Chesterfield. And we've been developing what we think is a pathway to a quantum compiler. And I'm incredibly excited about that research direction. The Information Initiative do make investments. For example, we're particularly proud of Guillermo Sapiro, the investments we made there in autism. We think that we made those investments at a time when institutions like NIH and NSF weren't so very interested. And we are super happy to see how successful Guillermo and Jerry Dawson have become since we started investing. We're also really happy with the investment we made over 5 years in gerrymandering. Like autism, this is not an area where NSF or other funding institutions were stepping up. So we're really happy to have filled that gap. The recent decision by the North Carolina courts that the current districting is unconstitutional, we think of that as 5 years of student work, and we are super proud of all that they've accomplished there.